really, 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 really telling as to why gold and silver and all of the world's commodities are behaving the way that they are. They're using the make-believe Western prices to accumulate all of it and to misdirect the Western public into thinking gold and silver are archaic relics of the past. You should just own cryptocurrency and Nvidia stock. At the same time, they're draining the exchanges of not just gold and silver, of grains like wheat, soybeans, and corn. You know, there was just a report that came out that the Chinese are cutting corn contracts tremendously, like in half, all the Western contracts. Why? Because Brazil is the second largest exporter of corn in the world, and they are now buying it from Brazil and valuing it, paying for it in yuan.
Gold has garnered a lot of attention in the last few weeks with its record-setting run. Since the end of February, gold is up nearly 7% and set an all-time record of $2,195 an ounce along the way. I've been arguing that silver is drastically underpriced given the supply and demand dynamics for quite a while. With gold setting up for an extended rally, silver could be poised for a record-setting launch of its own, and it just might steal gold's spotlight. Anticipation of Federal Reserve rate cuts and worries about de-dollarization sparked the gold's recent bull rally. I've argued that this is just the opening act. The U.S. government isn't going to suddenly become fiscally responsible or more reserved in using the power of the dollar as a foreign policy tool, so de-dollarization will likely continue and accelerate. When the economy cracks, we all know what the Fed will do. It will run to the rescue. It will slash rates to zero. It will relaunch quantitative easing. It will unleash another tsunami of easy money. What is gold going to do then? If this recent rally based on the hope of rate cuts was this big, the rally we'll see when the Fed actually delivers rate cuts far beyond what anybody today expects will likely send the price into orbit. Now, we'll show you more clips of Schectman, but first, like and subscribe to the channel. Enjoy the video.
It's really, 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 really telling as to why gold and silver and all of the world's commodities are behaving the way that they are. So I'm going to read this to you so that you understand, rather than try and paraphrase it. We can talk about it in a moment. He says, all that leads to adopting a new international currency is that we really don't need to go large scale. BRICS is enough. He said, the idea of the currency is that there will be two baskets. One basket will be of national currencies of all the countries involved in the process, like the SDR, which is the special drawing rights of the International Monetary Fund, by the way, but with more clear and understandable criteria. Okay, so they're going to have a basket of a currency that's based upon local currencies and a basket of commodities. Now, we assume that main commodity will be gold because it is the world's only other tier one reserve asset. And the central banks have been buying it and repatriating it from the Bank of England and the New York Fed like it's going out of style, right? So we understand that, right? And but here's the interesting part. Well, also, he says it should be in a digital form, which means it can be used without the banking system. So it will be at least 10 times cheaper than the present transactions through banks and currency exchanges. And what he's talking about there is the like the Chinese have CIPS, the CIPS, which is the Cross Interbank Payment System, or Project Mbridge, which was just utilized for a big trade. It allows these countries to trade, whether it be currencies as they are now or central bank digital currencies, outside the SWIFT system. That's what the Project Mbridge is. And that was developed by China, United Arab Emirates, and I think Singapore. But so, first of all, he's saying it's going to be a currency that will be digital, that will be traded outside the SWIFT system, and it will be a basket of commodities on one end and a basket of local currencies on the other end. So there's that's what it is, right? But here's the important part that I want people to understand, okay? And it's the most important part of everything. And he says this, the second part of the equation is price. For the moment, price is determined by Western speculation. We produce these commodities, we consume them, but we do not have our own price mechanism, which will balance supply and demand. During the COVID panic, the price for oil fell to nearly zero. Now, he's wrong there. It actually fell to negative $40 a barrel, which is kind of the whole underlying factor here of a commodity exchange that can distort reality through speculation to the point where oil is negative $40 a barrel. And they did that because there was more oil than they had the ability to hold it in any of the refineries or the holding tanks. So you had all of these ships sitting out in the middle of the ocean filled with oil, and there was no place to park it. So it was actually negative 40 a barrel. We'll pay you $40 to take our oil. That's how crazy it is. But anyways, he says, it's impossible to make any strategic planning for economic development if you do not control prices of basic commodities. Price formation with this new currency will get rid of Western exchanges of commodities. Now, I've been saying this for a long time, that the Shanghai Gold Exchange or the Moscow Gold Exchange or the exchange in Dubai will take over for the price setting mechanism of the West. We already know that the LME, the London Metals Exchange, was purchased by the Chinese a few years ago. The LME deals mostly in base metals like copper and zinc and lead and steel. They do something with precious metals, but not a lot. So this is not just about precious metals. China owns the LME, and they have just made a deal to where they are going to start warehousing the metals held and based backing the contracts trading on the LME. So Chinese will warehouse the metals in China, backing the contracts that are traded on the London Metals Exchange. You see here that they understand that the West has been suppressing the price of gold and silver. And they understand that, and they are using it to their advantage. They are using it against us until they have bled dry all of the shelves. In fact, they just came out and said that they want to build a new BRICS grain exchange. And they say it's likely to change the face of the world grain market tremendously, because after World War II, the United States wheat and corn exports dominated the markets. But now that's no longer the case. So they don't want to have to sell their wheat and corn where they're selling just or producing just as much or more than the U.S. is, where global prices are primarily determined on the Chicago Commodity Exchange. They want to have a BRICS grain exchange. They are going to have a Moscow Metals Exchange, a Shanghai Gold Exchange, a Dubai Gold Exchange. They are going to set the price for all of the world's commodities. They already own the LME. Do you see the transition here? They are using the suppression of all of the Western prices against us. Now,
in today's market news, silver price analysis, silver plunges to $24 after stubborn U.S. inflation report. Silver price falls vertically to $24 as sticky U.S. inflation allows the Fed to maintain a hawkish narrative. U.S. monthly headline and core inflation rose by 0.4% in February. On the other side, 10-year U.S. bond yields rally to 4.15% as hopes that Fed rate cut expectations would ease. Silver price plummets to $24.10 as the United States Bureau of Labor Statistics has reported that the consumer price index remains hot in February. Annual core CPI that strips off volatile food and energy prices grew at a higher pace of 3.8% against the consensus of 3.7%, but lower than 3.9% in January. In the same period, headline inflation rose at a higher pace of 3.2% against expectations and the former reading of 3.1%. The monthly headline and core inflation grew by 0.4%. Quick recap of silver technical analysis. Silver price faces selling pressure after testing the horizontal resistance plotted from the December 22nd high at $24.60. The overall trend is still bullish. However, a price correction move is expected before a fresh upside move. Is this dip a once-in-a-lifetime opportunity? Drop a comment, like, subscribe, and check our links in description for some massive bonuses. Let's get back into the video.
1 ounce form. The 1 ounce Birds of Prey series by the Royal Canadian Mint, they're the same price as silver maple leaves. I never even knew. And I've been, I mean, literally, I sold tens of thousands of the Red Tail Hawks. I own a bunch. I never even knew they made a half ounce coin. And Right. Maybe that's one of the special coins that they were able to make. These firms are able to do deals with the Royal Canadian Mint if they buy enough, and they buy these coins in sizes that they do not sell. they can have exclusivity to it. But whether it be half ounce red tail hawks or quarter ounce sea turtles or any of these quarter ounce Statue of Liberty coins, stuff that I've never heard of, never seen before, the premiums that have been sold to the public are horrific. And when you're paying, in essence, you know, I've seen 900, 1,000, 1,050 for a quarter ounce gold coin, and as high as $60, $70 an ounce or higher in 1 ounce silver coins, under the guise of it being a better price. You know, I talked to someone yesterday about it, and it was his mother who was taken by one of these companies, and he called them and said, "You guys know exactly what you're doing. You know exactly." He says, "Well, you know, no one sells this stuff, so we price it where we think it's fair." Well, that's exactly why they choose these coins that nobody sells, because there's no means to compare it with other companies. And I've done this for, you know, 34 years. I never knew there was a half ounce red tail hawk. I had never heard of a quarter ounce sea turtle or any of these coins that are made often by respectable mints. They're coins that they're specifically choosing that have low mintage that nobody buys or sells, and they are selling them at prices that are really, really, really predatory, I guess is all I can say. And unfortunately, almost every single one of the companies that does this is very deep into the retirement account industry. And they are selling it to elderly folks who have IRAs that will never get their money back out of it. And there is nothing more disgusting and diabolical that you could do than to rip off an elderly or a senior citizen or anyone, even someone who's, you know, 60 years old, who's worked their whole life to put a life savings together and nearing retirement, and listens to someone like you or me who thinks they're doing the right thing by buying gold and silver, only to find out that the company who they bought from, which was, you know, endorsed by a high-priced famous person, spokesman, who had no idea probably what kind of company he's actually endorsing or she, ends up getting taken to a level that I've never seen before, taken to a level that I honest to God believe is criminal, and it's predatory. And, you know, it's to the point where we make a couple of percent sometimes, usually less than that. These companies are making a couple hundred percent and doing it in a way that you don't have time on your side when you're talking about IRAs for older folks. And so you don't have the luxury of making a bad decision. And when the worst part about it, you know, it's like if you ever play golf, right? And you get to that one hole where you know you really want to hit a driver, but it would be much smarter to hit a 4-iron to put it right in the fairway, and you pull the 4-iron into the woods. And you try to do the right thing and you just screw it up. Well, that's exactly what this is. I know that's kind of a bad example, but it's the same thing. You try to do the right thing and you get screwed up by falling prey to a company that's very good at making you think you're doing the right thing and is very attractive, with the company spokesman thinking, well, geez, they would never do wrong by me, only to find out that you have been fleeced. And because this is a federally non-regulated industry, because there is no oversight, it lends itself to this type of behavior where, you know, people are left unchecked, can do a lot of really awful things. And I wonder, do these people have mothers and fathers? Because I don't understand how anyone could do this to someone, you know, who's 65, 70, 75, 80 years old. I hear all sorts of ages, only to find out that what they think they did was right, to set themselves up, protect themselves from what is coming, only put them in a position that they'll never recover from. And honest to God, it's one of the worst things I've ever seen. Puts a black eye on this industry. And I suggest anyone who what we are saying resonates, fractional coins like the sea turtle or a Statue of Liberty or 1.5 ounce silver coins that they paid 80, 90 bucks for, 2 ounce silver coins they paid 100 bucks for, call us. We'll talk with you. We'll let you know where you're at. We'll let you know if there's anything you can do. But the sad truth of it is, this is real, and it's not just happening. It's increasingly happening as gold and silver are getting a little bit more recognition, if you will, by the mainstream for for the environment that we find ourselves in. It's really awful.
What do you think of today's episode? Do you agree with Andy Schectman? Do you trade any numismatics at all? Post in the comments section your silver price prediction for the end of 2024 and check this video because it's a perfect fit for you. I see you on the other side.